Hello, folks. Let me introduce myself. I am the nameless one. Hee hee hee. That's the only moniker I have. Draw up your chairs while I tell you the charming little story. You all love soft, cushy living, but things are not always what they seem. Just when you think you have things going the way you want, you may be for a nasty surprise. Beware, friends, if in the life of Raleigh. A tale begins in East Coast City, where a gang of robbers pulled a daring bank hold-up. But the police have soon on the scene. The bullets flew thick and fast. The thieves tried to shoot their way out. One robber managed to reach the getaway car, but he handed in a satchel of stolen money. A cop slugged. Ended his earthly career. Raleigh, the driver of the car, waited no longer. He sped off. The boys are finished. Got to get out of here. But fast. At least I've got some of the dough. Raleigh miraculously got away and reached the hideout of a tough underground character known as Gas House Mom. I'm the only one that got away with 60 grand in a satchel now. Gotta get out of this country. I can handle it for you for 30 grand. Hey, that's half of all I got. Name man doesn't operate for peanuts. Take it or leave it. All right, you robber, you win. My friend, the Duchess, you give your way to South America. Once you take charge, the FBI will never pick you up your trail. Now hand over my share and I'll give you the directions. So about 2 weeks late, after being secretly shunted from hideout to hideout, found Raleigh bumping along a swampy road, somewhere deep in the slowly silent Florida Everglades. This place sure is spooky. The joint I'm headed for can't be far away. There's the only house I've seen in 20 miles. It must be the place. Three people emerged when the fugitive drew up before the ramshackle structure. It sure is a hole. Hope I don't have to stay here long. Hello, Mr. Raleigh. Welcome to the hoods. Heaven, we have been eagerly expecting you. I'm your hostess, the Duchess. These are my retinue, Lulu, and her little playmate, Bumbo. They will take care of your bags and the car. Come inside and make yourself comfortable. You'll stay here for a little while I arrange you to disappear completely. Ma'am has sent me several clients I've never failed. Don't take it too long, Duchess. A third-rate flop house would be better than this dump. But once inside, Raleigh was astonished. He gazed at a stupendous interior. Say, this map looks like the Waldorf. You see, Mr. Raleigh, you can't tell anything from the outside. You're only the finest of everything here. You live like a king. Raleigh relaxed as his hostess served cocktails. What boy, real Havana Mimitos. Just the kind I like. This cocktail's delicious. Then let me offer you a toast to a pleasant stay. We always enjoy our company. We had a visitor up to a few days ago. We'll be lonesome without you. Hey, our man's taken the tyres off my car. That's all right, mate. All trace of the car must be destroyed. We can sell the tyres. We don't waste anything, you know. Bobo then drove the car to the swamp and leaped out just in time. The car settled fast into the muddy bog, and in a few minutes it completely disappeared. Lulu came to announce, "Dinner is served. Just wait till the dining room, Mr. Raleigh. I'm good and hungry too." Raleigh continued to marvel at the elegance and surrounded him. Bongolulis, 1929. This is some wine, Duchess. It beats me. How? Nothing but the best. As I told you, we want you to enjoy yourself because we expect to gain a great deal from you too. The steak is so tender, the meat is so sweet. Ah, our meats are of pride, Mr. Raleigh. Lulu, take special care of that department. And so the days pass. I hope you're not becoming bored, Mr. Raleigh. No, indeed. Not living like this in the lap of luxury. In fact, you're flattering me up, haha. Oh, I'm so glad. Always did like it. A man with a bit of fat in him. She's getting to like me. I could do worse than stay right here. Live like the lord in the manor. Look, Duchess, you're a pretty sweet swell babe. How about you forgetting about the South American deal and you and me teaming up right here? Why, Mr. Raleigh, propose your marriage? You'll have to give me some time to think it over. Then Raleigh looked over his shoulder. Hey, what the? I just want to ask, Duchess, if you want steak or chops for dinner. Wow, you had me scared for a minute. Where do you get your fresh meat out in a good godforsaken place like this? Oh, we have the most modern deep freezer. Freeze. Once in a while, when left alone, Raleigh prowled the house. Wonder what's in the closet. When he opened the closet door, skulls. Ah, Mr. Raleigh, you've discovered my collection. My hobbies are anthropology, homoceptions, sapiens, especially, some hobby. After that, a sense of foreboding overtook Raleigh. This joint is getting on my nerves. Wish I could get started to South America. Those all here, 20-30 grand, could have a whole while of time with this in Rio. I want to hit the road, Duchess. When do I get started? Be patient, just a few days more. Sumpress meals slackened off. Raleigh was occasionally hungry. One afternoon he headed for the kitchen. I could stand a bit before dinner. Now be round. Where do they keep the meat? Maybe I could fry myself a chop. And when he opened the top of the deep freeze box. Now I know all her clothes disappear. There was one here just before I arrived. Now I know what that sweet steak. It appeared from the cleaver. Where he touched his heels as Bumbo joined the chase and the Duchess spurned him on. Don't let old dinner get away. The terrified man headed for the swamp. I've got to get out of here. The money doesn't count now. I've got to get out. But his oozy fingers of slime eagerly clutched their victim. I'm sinking. Bobo was right behind him with the agility of a monkey. Climbed out of on an overhanging branch. His ribs. Rips at some stout vine and I'm stuck. I can't move. I sink just like my car. Help. He neatly roped a panicked man and dragged him back to the far land. Good hunting in the swamp today. Yow. Surely you didn't think we'd let that ugly old swamp eat you up, did you, Mr. Raleigh? Eat? Let me out here. Please, let me go, Duchess. I'll give you all the dough, 30 grand. Why, Mr. Raleigh, don't be so naive. Already have all your money safely tucked away. The last thing Raleigh saw was Lulu's avid face, her lips drooling and an upraised hand, a heavy, gleaming, razor-sharp cleaver. That evening, the delightful little group sat down gratefully to their simple evening meal with excellent appetites. As I always said, I like a man with a bit of fat in him. Aha! That will be a lesson to you, dear readers. If you're reading The Life of Raleigh, beware! And don't say that the nameless one didn't warn you. Hee hee!